Any one of you know the meaning of this word adversarial? Okay. So the meaning. Yes. Anyone want to say anything? Okay. So the meaning of this word adversarial means something which is okay. Vaibhava said conflict. Closer. The answer is very much closer. Anyone else? Anyone else want to say anything? The meaning of the word adversarial. Vaibhava said conflict, which is very closer. Okay, so adversarial means a situation which is not very comfortable for us. Adversarial means a situation which is not very comfortable or not very cozy for us. That is called adversarial. Okay, so adversarial search means an environment where we have to reach to our target through a conflicting or rather to say competitive situation. This word is very much important. Competitive. This is the key word of this adversarial searching technique or adversarial searching strategy. We are trying to find out our target or we are trying to reach to our goal through a competitive environment. And to create this competitive environment, always this adversarial searching technique will accommodate more than one player. Okay, more than one player. In heuristic based search, it is always the searching technique which can involve only one user at a time. One user is going to follow the algorithm and one user is going to find out his or her goal or his or her target node from the initial stage. Okay, but in adversarial search, what we will find that there will be more than one number of players are involved in this searching strategy and everyone is trying to find out their target. Okay, everyone is trying to find out their target. And whenever more than one player are involved in this search, everyone is trying to beat the others. So that is the competitive situation, what I'm trying to say in adversarial search. So the most typical example of this adversarial search is a game. Any kind of strategic game is a very good example of this adversarial searching technique. Any strategic game, like from your tic-tac-toe to your chess, football, anything which is a strategic game, that can be under the domain of this adversarial searching technique. Okay, so any query up to this? Any query up to this? Please raise your hand if you have any query. Okay. So, how this competitive situation, now we are going to discuss how this competitive situation is going to be staged in adversarial searching technique. Say we are considering a game platform. We are considering a game which involved two players are involved in that game. Okay, now obviously both of these players will try to win, and if we consider these two players as player one and player two, if player one will always try to be a winner, then player 1 has to beat player 2, and this is true for player 2 also. If player 2 wants to win, he or she has to beat player 1. Okay, so this will create a competitive situation. Let's start with an example of tic-tac-toe. I am just showing you in these notes, I am just trying to show you this tic-tac-toe example. And if anyone have any query, I have repetitively, I am trying to say you that if anyone have, any one of you have any query, please raise your hand. Okay. Okay, when we will consider, in the light of this adversarial searching technique, for this game we need to create a tree. First, the first day, don't write anything on your whiteboard right now, because I am showing the notes. If you write over here, the others will be, it will be difficult for the others to see these notes. Okay, so no one, just restrict yourself to write anything over the whiteboard right now. Yes, Imandeep, tell me.
Sir, please.
Imandeep, louder, please. I can't hear you clearly.
Sir, there are some lines on the screen.
Yes, that's why I'm telling that someone has drawn something. If don't draw anything over the screen, because it will be hard for the others to see the notes. Okay, don't draw anything right now over the screen. Okay, so what I'm trying to say, that is the first thing for a game, that we have to prepare a game tree. We have to prepare the game tree, okay? And this preparation of game tree is just like this one. This is the example of a tic-tac-toe game, a very common game. All of you know that, this tic-tac-toe game. It's a two-player game. Now, before going to create the game tree for tic-tac-toe, what the consideration we need to know, or what are the parameters we have to think about? Okay, so first of all, how many players are involved in that game? In tic-tac-toe, there are two players are involved in that game. Then how many possibilities for a single board, as it is a board game, for a single board, how many possibilities are there in a tic-tac-toe? Okay, in a tic-tac-toe, how many possibilities are there in a tic-tac-toe game? How many possibilities are there? Tell me, how many possible moves are there for a particular board? How many possible moves are there for a particular board? Tell me, for a tic-tac-toe game. Say for an initial condition, we are in an initial condition, the board is empty right now. So how many possibilities are there for a single player for a tic-tac-toe game? Anyone? Any one of you, raise your hand. Any one of you, how many possibilities are there for a single player at the initial condition of a tic-tac-toe game, when the board is completely empty or completely blank? It is very easy. 9 possibilities are there. 9 possibilities, yes. Vaibhav has said 9. Yes, it is true. It is right. 9 possibilities are there. When the board is empty at the initial stage, for a single player, there are 9 possibilities. Now, whenever a player has given a cross or a cross or a zero in a single cell, what will be the possibilities remaining for the next player? Obviously, 9 minus 1, that will be 8. Okay. So, that is a single, for a single move. Now try to think about, for a particular move, that say I am the first player, player 1. I have given a cross over the board. Initially, I have 9 possibilities. When the board is empty, at the starting stage, when the board is empty, I have 9 possibilities. And I have given a cross in a cell. Okay? So now, the next player, for the next player, how many possibilities are there? What is the expansion of this game tree? Can you tell me? I am just repeating that for a tic-tac-toe game, for a player 1, at the initial stage, the total board is empty, blank. Now, how many possibilities of the first player? There are 9 possibilities. Within these 9 cells, in any one of these cells, the player 1 can put his or her cross. Okay? Now, according to that, how many possibilities of the second player? How many possibilities of the second player? Can you tell me? Just see 8. The diagram in the note. 8. Boibhav has said 8. Anyone else? See, as a player 1, the player 1 has the 9 possibilities. So if we consider, when I am player 2, I have to consider all of these 9 possibilities of this player 1. If I denote all of these cells starting from the upper left corner, starting from the upper left corner, 1, 2, 3, horizontally, row wise, 1, 2, 3, then the second row, 4, 5, 6, and then the third row, 7, 8, 9. So if we have these 9 cells, and we, as a player 1, I have the option to put my cross any one of these 9 cells. So as a player 2, he or she has to think about all of my move. He or she, as a player 2, he or she has to consider all of my 9 moves, not only a single move. If I put my cross in cell 1, what will be his or her move against me? If I put my cross in cell 2, then what will be the move of the player 2 against me? If I put my cross in cell 3, then what will be the move of the player 2 against me? So in this way, player 2 has to consider all of the possible moves of player 1. So initially, player 1 can have 9 possible moves in the initial state. So player 2 will consider all of these 9 moves. Player 2 has to consider all of these 9 moves. All of these 9 moves are player 1. So now the tree is going to increase. Initial state, it was a blank. It was a blank tree. Blank board. There is no cross or zero over there. Now the move of player 1. Now the move of player 1 and we will create 9 possibilities for player 1. 9 children has been created by player 1. Okay, I am just trying to open a whiteboard. Okay, I am just trying to open a whiteboard. Okay, all of you can see this whiteboard. I think all of you can see this whiteboard. Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
okay. Sir. So this is the first condition. Listen carefully. This is the first condition. Okay. Empty board is there. Now, what are the possibilities we can create for player one, P1? It is the first move of player one. So it can be like this. Okay, can you understand? Okay, so from the initial state of the root node is the empty board, and from there, first move is player one, and we have created 9 children for player one according to the 9 position of this cross mark over the board. Okay, now it is the move of player two, and that is also one very important condition of any game. This type of strategic game like tic-tac-toe or chess, that every player will get the opportunity for alternate move. Player one will give a move, then player two will get the opportunity to place his or her move. So this is an alternate movement game. Okay, so this is the movement of player one. Now player two, P2,